I'm JT Rose. Welcome to our second in a four-part series on building end-to-end applications with Azure Blockchain Service. Today, I'm joined in the studio by Kale Teeter from the Azure Blockchain Engineering team.
Nice to be here.
Kale, good to have you. Kale, last week we had Jason Anderson, the PM that's been building Azure Blockchain Service, on the show, and we talked about how it allows you to really simply build, deploy, and manage the underlying blockchain infrastructure in Azure. The second step, once you have that solid foundation, is to sort of codify the logic that you're sharing with other organizations in the form of smart contracts that would then live on that blockchain network. Is that right?
That's right. So, looking at the past, and if we take a step back of where we came from here, we had the infrastructure deployment that we're talking about with JT that we're simplifying and continue to refine. And then on top of that, now we want to improve the developer experience. And so part of that is kind of looking at what actually existed in the space today for what JT was talking about. So once we have a ledger stood up, we can't really do much with it. We need to actually build some assets, some smart contracts, and ultimately we want to lead up to building an application on this thing. And so if you take a look at this slide, you know, basically in the history of like what's happened with blockchain and blockchain technology, it's been very kind of decoupled. There's been a lot of different pieces that exist out there that are really good in the open source space. And it really took some special skill or some special experience to even know which tools to use at the right time, you know, kind of thing. And so basically walking through that, if we look at what the history showed us, when we do development, we're building smart contracts primarily in the first stages here. Then we need to go get a bunch of tools, right? So we'll go out to the open source community. Again, rich tools out there. We've had some of these in Block Talk before, such as Truffle and some of the other folks. And, you know, those are great tools, and we want to basically highlight them and show the power of them. But part of that is getting them in front of users and showing them, like, the power of how they can actually use these tools. And so finding the right tools is one thing, and then deploying the ledger. And we've been on a journey there at Microsoft, you know, building things like templates all the way up to the Azure Blockchain Service, which is really a single click to kind of get that powerful blockchain infrastructure underneath.
A managed experience.
Yep. And then we go beyond that into deployment. So we want to start deploying these assets out to the chain. And part of that is understanding how the tools work. And part of it is understanding how blockchain works. Mm. And so we're trying to smooth the edges over there a little bit with some of our tooling, which leads to here.
Yeah. So what are we sharing at Build this year? What's the new integrations and experiences that we have for developers?
Yeah, it's great. I think if you take a look at what this slide is showing here, you can see at the center of this is Visual Studio Code, the integrated developer environment. And you can notice inside of that block, we actually have the different partners we've been partnering with on this, Truffle being a key one there, as well as the VS Code Solidity product built by Juan Blanco in the consensus group. Also, Remix is in there as well. So we've been working with the Ethereum Foundation, again, on how to bring these things together.
Sure.
And then basically, if you take a look at this slide, you can see that on the left side, we have our Create New Project experience. So when people want to start building applications, you know, if you're staring at a blank screen with a tool set, that's one thing. If you have some guidance around it to say, here's some templates to help you kind of drive that. Again, leveraging the power of, you know, our partners here, such as Truffle Unbox in this case.
Yeah.
So using some of those features, but kind of wrapping in an experience that makes it a little easier for people to discover. On top of that, we have our ledger creation. As we mentioned before, and we showed in the first video in this series, you can actually go to the portal, you can deploy, you know, a Azure Blockchain Service. But in this case, we can do it directly from in the IDE, which we think is key, you know, to the developer experiences. If we can keep the developer in the IDE and keep him productive in that environment, you know, it's a better story than if we're jumping around to different tools or different portals and things like that.
So you can deploy a smart contract to a ledger network that's already been created in the Azure portal, but you can also create and deploy the ledger natively in Visual Studio Code.
That's correct.
Outstanding.
And even things like when we talk about ledgers, we're even talking about things like Ganache, which is a local blockchain development environment, which people typically use when they start developing on blockchain. They don't immediately want to push it up to some bigger infrastructure. They want to try it locally, get this thing running, and then how do I migrate that into something like Azure Blockchain Service or even PublicNet?
Cool. So this is, you're able to hear now with these new tools, create and compile smart contracts in Visual Studio Code using open source tools like Truffle, and the Solidity extension that we have already, and then deploy the smart contracts to either public Ethereum, a consortium network in Azure Blockchain Service, or locally using a tool like Ganache.
That's correct. So we think we have a good thing there. And it's also a tool that allows for extension, right? So as other services come along and other things that we want to plug in here for either the left side or the right side of what you're seeing on the screen here, we have an environment that makes it very easy to bring those things together.
Right.
The other thing I will highlight, it's in the bottom left corner here, is the automated configuration, which is another little stumbling block that people run into is, once I've created my ledger, once I've created my source code, how do I, you know, configure that tool set so that I can communicate with these different blockchains? Mm-hmm. Because it's a little bit of an art there too, understanding, you know, what's the RPC endpoint, which port numbers, and all these different things that are involved there. And so we're taking a step to kind of automate that. Again, we want to have an experience so that we can handle guys who are relatively new to the space, so we can automate what we can there. But if you're an expert in it, you can totally break right through it and go into the expert level details if you need to. So we're not hindering anybody from that perspective.
Cool.
So let's take a look at what this actually looks like, the experience here. So we're in Visual Studio Code. I have the extension running here, and you see this is basically a project that got scaffolded out here. And how did that get scaffolded out? As part of the installation of this tool set, you'll see there's some new commands that get added to Visual Studio Code, such as create a new Solidity project, creating and connecting to consortiums. So there's a lot of different things that are coming here. You also notice that down here in the lower left corner, we see this Azure Blockchain Consortium. And we can see there's something there right now. I'll talk about that in a second. But basically, we're able to create and connect to different consortiums in here. And so if I wanted to connect to an existing consortium, you can see that we give you a nice little kind of wizard experience here through Visual Studio that allows you to say, hey, I want to connect to a local Ganache that's already running. So I could totally, from the expert level, if I understand what Ganache is and I have that running, I can go do that right from here. Azure Blockchain Consortium. So the Azure Blockchain Service that we have running here, we can have people connect to ones that maybe IT even provision. Sure. So for enterprises, this is really important to not just have the developer able to create them, but also have the IT staff create them and we can connect to them.
Great.
So if we do that, this is kind of more complex when you can see that it comes up and asks me for a subscription. This is actually reading out of my live Azure subscription. So you can see the GUID here and the name for my subscription. You can see my resource group. And then in here, you saw it hung there for a little bit. And what it's doing is actually going and querying Azure for any consortiums I have running there. I've already pre-deployed an Azure Blockchain Service consortium, so it's right there. And it's actually registered here, so we won't need to wait for that. But it basically pops up down here. Every one of your Azure Blockchain Service consortiums, you can register down here, essentially. So this is the first one that I have here. So if we had multiple, you could obviously support having multiple here. And then underneath, we have our member block, which is basically showing who we are on that network as a member. We do the same thing for local, for running Ganache or public net. The other thing you'll notice is that in the contracts, we can do all the normal stuff, compilation. And if you really want to drop down to a terminal window, you can do everything just like expert level. If you want to be in Truffle, you want to control all those kind of things. If you don't know kind of what those tools are, you can essentially just click on your smart contract and you'll see in the menu here, we've actually added stuff for you. So we have the ability to trigger a Truffle compile, which is the build contracts here, the ability to do the deployment. When you do the deployment, obviously you'll be prompted for which chain you actually want to deploy it to. And then we take care of that automatic configuration that I was talking about earlier, which essentially boils down to, let me clear some screen real estate here. Basically, this configuration will get automated for you. You can see in here I have the link actually out to my Azure Blockchain Service, and then here's my local Ganache environment. So this gets created for me automatically. And then also on the migration side, we'll go ahead and build out the scaffolding over here to do this for you. So you don't have to write any code to do any deployment. You literally build the source code, right click and deploy.
That's awesome.
So we think this is really powerful, to help people as they start building their systems over here and start building, the core functions. So you mentioned the infrastructure we built up first. Now we've layered on building the actual assets like the smart contracts, the core layer to our application.
Right. And I think in the next couple of episodes, you and Chris Segura are going to talk about how to use the serverless tools in the Azure Blockchain Dev Kit to interact with the ledger network we built in video one and the smart contracts that we've built in this episode, sending either data to those smart contracts, data that is relevant to the smart contract, or reading data off of it. So looking forward to those episodes as well.
Yeah, I mean, we really want to give the whole life cycle to the application and the blockchain application. So we think this is a good model.
Cool. So I encourage you all to follow along. You can follow us here on Channel 9 or over on YouTube. And we're also very active on social media. So you can follow us on Twitter at MSFT Blockchain. Kale, thanks for joining us today.
Yep. Thanks, JT.
Cool.